good afternoon and welcome to CW Sport Radio, bringing you non-league football, women's football, and as always, any other sport we can get our little mitts on. But this afternoon, we are, as it's a Sunday, we turn our attention to the women's game, and we're here in Suffolk for what's a bit of an emotional occasion, because it's the last time that Cambridge United women will be playing at Milton Hall Town's Recreation Way grounds. Not just this season, but period, because obviously in the summer they will be moving to their new home at St Neots Town. So we'll be bidding a fond farewell to the Recreation Way ground here at Milton Hall at the end of the game. But first of all, thank you very much for tuning in. I'm Chris Walker, I'll be your commentator. So Cambridge will line up with Sam Smith in goal, four at the back, Carrie Bennett on the left, Abby Davis on the right. There's no Emma Jenkins today. So Fran Goff and Gemma Moore, very youthful-looking central defence partnership there. In central midfield, expect to see Charlotte Chris probably alongside Vicky Neal, with Amy Howlett probably being used more on the right wing, with Jay Bell on the left and Molly Cooper and Becky Shepherd up front. Amy Howlett, skipper's aside today, and the side's already out in front of us here in the main stand. And Recreation Way, just going through there. The niceties before the start of the action, that's a respect handshake, so Ipswich Town in familiar all blue kit with Mike Trim. We could potentially finish 6 points shy. So get underway, and for the first time in a long time that we've done the commentary, Cambridge are kicking up the slope here at Milton Hall. Richard Chris. Zooming out and lifting over the ball over the top there, and Molly Cooper nips in on the left hand side on the edge of the penalty area. Up against Harriet Petley, and the ball comes off. That's again fed out the cross in from the left hand side. This is across the penalty area. So part of that rather youthful looking central defensive partnership this afternoon, Gemma Moore about to do her best Rory De Lapp impression. So she's going to be is incoming. It's going to be a long throw and a long cue. I've been proved wrong. Gemma then throws a short one in, and the shot comes in, and that's a shot in out of the edge of the box. And Howlett throws one in there and pops it in, and that is the lead out of nowhere, caught flat-footed, and Ipswich have fallen behind on only 4 minutes, and more importantly, Cambridge United have taken the lead on 4 minutes. So a throw-in taken there by Libby Wilson playing on the right this afternoon. Cambridge get the ball, and now Molly Cooper has got past Petley. Molly Cooper coming through the middle, trying a wrong foot. The defender trying a wrong foot. Amy Stretch there. Well, on one side, it did look like that ball had actually bounced for a ground ball, but the flag is up on the far side by Andy Drain. And Davis tries again, second time of asking. And look like Cooper, they're just getting a little dink in the back there. And again, I think this is already identified one of the major threats to their defence this afternoon. And Molly Cooper just getting a little bit of rust off. Now Chris with the ball through the middle up to Cooper. Now linking up to Shepherd. The ball runs for Jay Bell, who chips one on Wallace. Nice little save there from Fang, but a good shot there from Jay Bell on the edge of the area. And both hands needed there by the factor just to push that over the crossbar. Again, nice little move there. Hilson looking for runners and all over ahead of Welton, and Cambridge bringing up on the left. Bell to Chris, who sends the ball forward. Cooper racing on for it, and Cooper in plenty of space on the left-hand side now. Molly Cooper powering into the box as Molly Cooper, and brings out a save from Flagg, and the rebound put over the bar there by Shepherd. So there is some serious firepower on the bench for Joe Sheehan side at half time, should he need. And let's say Paige Wakefield on 7 goals this season in the league, and League Cups on FA Cups. Now Cooper breaking again into the box and cuts into the left side of the centre. Cooper. And just that Wins are coming back, just coming over. I think just taking deflection on stretch there. Kane's lead just by that one goal to nil. Throwing it right inside towards it. Cooper's holding off the challenge there. Off cage goes down. Play continues, and now the mantle picked up by Charlotte Crisp. Cross comes in up towards Jay Bell and turns it over the keeper. But not on target, sadly. Now for Cambridge, it's Abby Davis just in front of a contrary position with that throw in up towards Morley Cooper. Just intercepted there, the ball headed clear. And we can confirm Dave's only on his way to Bristol. So that's far enough from Suffolk on the Sunday afternoon. Now break for Ipswich out to Kelly on the right hand side. And a lot of space here. Cross comes in. Met by the head there with Thomas, who can't direct it. And the shot on the turn there brings out a good stop there from Sam Smith. Ipswich ladies still trail Cambridge United. Ipswich Town FC women, rather. There's a new name, they changed the name in midway through the season. Trailing Cambridge United women by a goal to nil. There's a Amy Stretch. Wins that header, and the ball just spread across the defence again. And again, trying to release Charlotte Kellett on that right hand side. And the go to players, Kellett, has been a different animal since playing out on the right wing. And a bit of a collision there in the middle between Kellett and Vicky Neal. Play continuing. Thomas now for Ipswich on the right wing. Level with a penalty area. Just goes a little bit further forward. The cross comes in and headed in, and the ball turned in there by Zoe Cossey for the equaliser. That's 71 minutes with Cossey, and now Cambridge with Vicky Neal leading the line. The ball out now to Jay Bell. Bell will cross into the edge of the area. It's headed clear, now put back in by Charlotte Crisp. And Molly Cooper trying to challenge, but more clears for Ipswich. Break on again. Lafayette's just showing too much about to Abby Davies. And without with team positions as it stands, as it would stand, a draw would be so okay. Well, now Cooper chips one in, and the lead's been restored, and Molly Cooper gets her 14th for the season, and Cambridge go 2-1 up. And just rather calm and casual as you like, composure there from Cooper to just loft the ball over a rather frustrated looking Sean Fagan goal. And if body language could tell a thousand words, I think the body language there from the Ipswich keeper now speaks volumes. And elsewhere, I don't know what on earth's been put in the tea at half-time at Norwich City, but they were 2-0 down at half-time. They currently lead Billericay by 4-2. As Howlett puts the ball into the box, and it's free for Cambridge. No, it's not. The flag's up. The flag's up. Celebrations are cut short. Becky Shepherd-Ford that was in, but as soon as the contact was made, the flag was up by Frank Gonsalves on this near side. So it won't count. To get the ball deep into Cambridge territory. Wakefield with the ball up onto the edge of the area. It's a crump, but Carrie Bennett cuts it out. The clearance. Ball down again now. Here's Wakefield. Out to Kellett, who just makes some space on that right hand side. Kellett being shadowed there by Jay Bell. Kellett still on the ball. Jay Bell resisting a temptation to dive in, just trying to hold the winner's run as the cross comes in. Up to Thomas in the box. Yes! And that's the equaliser. That one just curled into the corner.
Come on.
To all. So Stretch with the free kick. We're now in the time added on. And now Amber Campbell nearly gets the ball clear, but it's closed down by Paige Wakefield. Neither side wanting to make a slip up here. At the moment, they both get a point each, and it would mean that Cambridge would finish seventh. There you go. Don't want to make a mistake here, because if I did concede a third, that means that Ipswich were going. Here comes Lafayette. And oh dear, curse of the commentator strikes again. And the third has been conceded. And that's Lafayette scoring on her debut. That's my fault, yeah, it's my fault. Can't blame the defence, it's my fault on this one. I'd take full blame on that one. It's me saying if they go behind, and say as I was about to complete. Yeah, well, might as well start, finish the season as I ended. Commentator's curse, well and truly. And as I was about to try and complete before Abby Lafayette did that. If Cambridge were to lose today, they would switch places with their visitors and end up in eighth. And at the moment, that looks like that's going to happen. So I can only apologise to everyone listening. You can blame me for that one. Bridge is out, and the ball now played out to the right-hand side. It's forceful. Can Cambridge keep this in play? And Joe Moore being forced on the back foot. And that is a full-time whistle. And it has indeed ended. Cambridge United women 2, Ipswich Town FC women 3. Well, that is about all we've got time for this afternoon, and indeed this season on CW Sport for our Women's National League coverage. I'd just like to say a massive, massive thank you to every single one of you this season who's been listening in, who's actually taken time out to tweet us, to send us messages of support and feedback during the games. And so once again, we will, of course, we'll be back next season, say former Nets, but for the very final time, here from Recreation Way at Mildenhall Town. Thank you very much for listening. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, and indeed enjoy the rest of your bank holiday weekend. So from all of us here at Mildenhall Town, and from me, Chris Walker, your commentator, thanks so much for listening again, and mind how you go. Bye-bye for now. Ta-da.